Welcome back to STS. In today's tutorial, we're going to find the equation of the tangent line at a specified point. That specified point is also called the point of tangency. In this particular example, that point is its coordinates are 1, 3, and we're doing this on function f. Here we have function f defined as f of x is equal to 2x plus 1 over x. I'm going to do a little rewrite here just so I can put this in a form that I like better for doing the derivative. So f of x is equal to, let's keep the 2x, and instead of writing 1 over x, let's write that in exponential form, where that's really x raised to the negative 1. I like using a power rule. The quotient rule would have worked just as fine. It's also pretty easy, but I just prefer the power rule. Let's go ahead now and take the derivative of each one of these terms. So f prime of x is equal to, I keep the constant 2. The derivative of x is just 1. Now for the power rule, I have to bring this negative 1 out front. So that's going to be plus this negative 1 times, I keep the base of x, and I need to subtract 1 from the current power. So negative 1 minus 1 gives me a negative 2. At this point, let's do a rewrite just to clean up a bit. I have 2 times 1 to give me 2. Plus here I have a negative 1 over x squared, and again I can rewrite to make this 2 minus 1 over x squared. So this here is the derivative. They've given me the value for x, so I'm going to input that value into the derivative. So f prime of 1 is equal to 2 minus 1 over 1 squared. Well, 1 squared is just 1, so this is really 2 minus 1, which tells me the derivative at this point is just 1. So this here is the slope, also called m. So now that I have the slope and I have a point, I'm going to use the point slope formula to write my equation for the tangent line. So that's y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1, where x1 and y1 are the point in question. So here y minus y1, which is going to be 3, is equal to m, which we found to be 1 as the slope. I write my x and minus x1, which I know is 1. Now I can just, I'm going to distribute this 1, which really keeps it the same, x minus 1, and I'm going to add 3 to both sides. So when doing that, these 3's cancel. I have y is equal to x plus 2, and this here is the equation for the tangent line. Let's go ahead and pull up the calculator so we can verify this graphically. Alright, with the calculator, I'm going to press y equals. Notice I already have, I already have the function in place. And now let's go ahead and graph it. Alright, with the graph, you'll notice that I also put the point on here with the green box around it, the point 1, 3. Everything's happening in our first quadrant, so let's take a zoom in there. So let's click zoom. Let's press alpha and then math for our first quadrant. We see that we can focus on an x value of 2 as the maximum and a y value of 4 as the maximum. So let's change the window. So the max x value is 2, and the max y value, let's make that 4. And then again, let's take a look at the graph. So there it is, zoomed in. Now let's go ahead and add in the equation for the tangent line, and that there was x plus 2. Alright, let's graph again. We see the x plus 2 comes in showing, the line x plus 2 comes in showing the point of tangency. We see it does go through that point. And the one last thing, let's do second trace, and let's find the derivative of this function, the blue function here, which is what it's already set on. I want to find that at position 1. So let's select it. And we see that it's telling us that at position 1, the derivative is this decimal point 9 repeating. And again, the calculator uses some type of approximation. But for what we're doing here, for these types of problems, where for all intents and purposes, this here is in fact 1. That sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to that YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.